All right, Tay, well, we are back talking all things Liberty A-League finals. And just to recap from last weekend, we saw the high-flying Jets knock out Western United at Tarnit. And as well, I'm not going to say we were right, but we did both agree that perhaps Melbourne Victory and the Central Coast Mariners would go to a penalty shootout. It did exactly that. And it's not for the heroics of Casey Dumont, who we know is an absolute maestro in penalty shootouts. Central Coast may not have gotten up, but that's the situation. That's where we're up to, which now means that Newcastle and the Central Coast Mariners will face off against Melbourne City and Sydney FC in the next couple of weeks of semi-finals. And just as a quick explainer, can you run through what the next couple of weeks of football are going to look like?
Yeah, so the higher placed team on the table, Melbourne City and Sydney FC, got to choose whether they play away or at home first. Both teams chose to play away first. Over these two legs, the away goals rule will not be used. So it's the aggregate over these two games. Obviously, whoever scores the most goes through. If it is even after the two legs, it'll be extra time and then potentially penalties if we can't find a winner at the end of that second leg.
Ooh, a big couple of weeks coming up then. The first game we're going to talk about is, of course, on Sunday afternoon, the 3 p.m. kickoff, which is going to be the Newcastle Jets, up against Melbourne City. That one is at Maitland, as you mentioned, the home ground of the Jets. How do you think this one's going to play out?
Well, I think we can throw out the first head-to-head meeting between these teams, which was in Newcastle, a 3-2 win for Melbourne City, but Holly McNamara scored a hat-trick that day for Melbourne City, while also sadly tearing her anterior cruciate ligament and ruled out for the rest of the season, and Emily Van Egmond was playing for Newcastle. So the form line on that one is a little bit false. However, more recently, they did play in Melbourne. It was a 2-0 win to Melbourne City and a vital game as they went on to finish top of the league. It's also the last time Newcastle lost, so I feel as though their run of good results has come after some of the things they learned out of this game. I think Melbourne City may have made a strategic error not playing the first leg at home. I think handing the advantage to Newcastle in front of 4,000, maybe even 5,000caucus fans at Maitland, this could be Newcastle's chance to build a lead going into the second leg. I think Newcastle will win the first leg. Maybe it'll be narrow, but I do think they'll have their noses in front to take back to Melbourne.
Well, that's a big call. And as well, you know, Newcastle, first time in finals since 2017-18. So it's been a long time between finals football for them. They've got so much to play for. And we know that the community gets around the Newcastle team so very well. So I think the Newcastle girls are going to be absolutely chomping at the bit to get.
What's your pick, Grace? Do you think just for the fast leg? You can't be totally wrong because, you know, you're not saying who's going through to the grand final, but who do you think will have their nose in front after the first leg?
You know what? I wouldn't be surprised if we see a draw in this first game and then the second one all coming down to that result, whether that goes to extra time and pens. But I wouldn't be surprised if we see a draw given the goal scoring form at the moment of Newcastle, but that too of City, who have perhaps even flown a little under the radar by their standards across the course of the season. So if we saw a draw in this first fixture, I wouldn't be surprised. On the same day, later that afternoon and up at Industry Group Stadium, we see the Central Coast Mariners hosting Sydney FC in their first leg of the semis. What do you make of that one?
Well, Sydney may have a lot of attacking weapons and they may have Courtney Vine, but it's worth remembering that over the two games against the Central Coast Mariners, they only scored one goal in the home and away season. First time was a nil-all draw in Gosford. Second time was a 2-1 win to the Central Coast. And the only goal Sydney have scored past the Mariners this season was when Ash Irwin, an outfielder, was in goal. They haven't actually scored against a Mariners goalkeeper this season. This is where I think two legs might be to Sydney's advantage, because the Mariners can't just lock this down and play for penalties from minute one. With that said, and this may not be the best sales pitch for the game, I'm sure it will be tense, but I think there's less likely to be a goal than to be a goal in this game. I think it's going to end in a draw, and again, it will be all to play for in the second leg, Sydney.
That's not a bad shout either. These are our two best defensive teams in the league, conceding the fewest number of goals across the course of the regular season. So I think you might be onto something there. I think the Mariners are going to get the edge in this one. They're going to have a packed Industry Group Stadium. I think similar to Newcastle, the Coast community gets around this team with such great force. So I think for the first leg, maybe the Mariners might edge them in front, and it's going to be a very interesting conversation come this time next week to see how these first ones come together. Can't wait to see all of this unfold over the next 7 days. And remember that you can catch all of these games live and free on 10 Play or catch them on Paramount+.